All right, hopefully everyone can hear me, see me. I've got the waiting room is off. We are recording. Okay, let's get going. I am super excited for tonight. I feel like I say that every week, but kind of got my new office set up. So hopefully Wi-Fi should still be good up here, but it's cool. I used to never be able to talk in the other room because that was next to my daughter's room. And now I'm all the way upstairs. So I can give Brian the bedroom. I can have my own space and we're good to go. So welcome. Welcome to our team call tonight. It is Monday night, September 21st. Crazy. I'm pretty sure yesterday or today was the first official day of fall. And I know for a lot of us, like the temperature went like that this weekend, which I love fall. But hopefully you're all having a really, really good start to your week and that you had a really good weekend. Tonight, it's going to be all about quarter four vision and goals. And more specifically, you guys, the difference between vision and goals, because they're not the same thing. So what I really hope to get out of tonight is to just be able to pour into you guys. Hi, what's up? Pour into you guys and just help you feel re-inspired, because I know that we all need that. I try to bring what I would like someone to say to me, because just like you guys, I have ups and downs. I have days when I feel on top of the world, and I have days where I feel like I did absolutely nothing. So I really just want to bring the real talk, but I also want to bring hopefully some inspiration. And we're going to talk about a lot of things that are upcoming for October, a lot of things that are exciting about, you know, the rallying together as we head into quarter four, which basically just means the last 3 months of the year, which is crazy. So we have October, November, December, quarter four. And we're about a week and a half before we hit that. So what I want to do is get started. We're going to go over recognition. We're going to go over announcements. Get ready, because we do have a rank advancement. So we got to do our dance party. I don't know how to dance party without it looking like I'm earthquaking, but I don't care. I'm going to do it. So let's get started. Let me share my screen. Okay. I'm going to keep this minimized for now. So tonight, obviously, is quarter four goals and vision. I hope you find it very, very helpful. Success Club is obviously the building block, the cornerstone of our business. And I'm going to speak a little bit later on Success Club and basically why, just the mindset around it. But I really want to recognize everyone on the board, because it's awesome to see your hard work. I proofread this, so hopefully no one's name is on there twice or three times, but you never know. So I'm at 24 points. Sarah P is 16. Amanda is 14. Heather is 8. Kayla is 8. Paige, 8. Amanda, 6. Catherine, 6. Marie, 6. And Crystal, 6. For Success Club, awesome, awesome job. You guys locked it in already for on the 21st. And if you do have a spouse account that you are also working, I combine them. So instead of putting your husband that probably no one knows, I just combine your numbers. But of course, if you are building a spouse or a family member, you guys know your business is most important to lock in Success Club. Okay. That is where you get the recognition. That is where Beachbody starts counting your consecutive months to earn really cool things when you hit the 12-month mark and the 24-month mark of never missing SC. So your business always, always priority to lock in Success Club for the leads as well. Success Club 4, you guys are knocking on the door. Kat, Kayla, and Tessa. And Success Club 2, you have helped one person. Time to put pedal to the metal. If you're not on this board too, time to put pedal to the metal, because we've got 10 days left in the month and it is time to work. So Sophia, Heather, Brandy, Marissa, Kathy, awesome job, you guys. And I got to get my video out. We have an official rank advancement today. So you guys should probably have seen this last Thursday, but Brandy Duncan is officially a one-star diamond coach. Blow it up in the chat. We're gonna do a dance party in just a second. But before we do, I just have to say, let me stop sharing this for a second so we can dance party. Brandy's worked so hard, and huge shout out to Crystal as well, because Crystal is her diamond. You guys, Crystal had to hold diamond, which you all know, when you hit diamond, you're not solid. Typically, you can go like this. So Crystal has been working so hard to maintain her diamond. Brandy had to maintain at least 10 personally sponsored coaches. She had to maintain certain volume level, and she had to maintain having her diamond for 6 total weeks. So that is so huge, because a lot of us, I've started qualifying for ranks and then I've fallen off. So the fact that she has gotten to that rank is awesome. And if you didn't listen live, she was announced on the National Wake Up Call as a 1-star diamond coach, which is huge. And then when 2-star hits, you guys, it is like a whole new world for your business. Let's do a little dance party. Let me put the music on for Brandy. Let me get her some of my 2012 things. Let's do this one. I thought we've done this one before. Okay. If you want to video it, put it up. I don't always remember to share, as you guys know. Let's dance. Wait, not that. Not that song. Hang on. I want to change it. Okay, ready? Dance it out. Woo!
Feeling my way through the darkness. Guided by a beating heart. I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start. They tell me I'm too young to understand.
All right.
They say I'm caught up in a dream.
I have to put my phone down because I can't dance with one hand, but I hope we got it. Okay. Back to our screen. Congratulations. Blow that up in the chat too, because that is huge. And then I always have cardio after I do those dance parties. I hope we do a dance party every week. If you guys rank advance, we're doing dance parties. And if you can like send me a song request, let's do that. I will rock out to your song request so you don't have to pick my weird 2012 music. All right, back to share. So let's get right back into it. Okay, now I can be full screen. So announcements, let's roll right into announcements. Diamond Weekend is officially happening November 5th through the 8th. I know some of you guys that are flying in got crazy deals, so that's awesome. We have one spot left, and what we're doing that as is the next person to achieve Diamond rank gets that last invite to our Diamond Weekend. We've got other things happening too, but I know a lot of us, including me, is our love language is like being together and having memories and having moments together. So being able to give that to you guys is so huge, and to reward your hard work. I am grateful to be able to do that. So one more person, whoever it is in the downline, I don't care if I'm your personally sponsored, mentored, coach, whatever, as long as you're in this downline and you achieve Diamond, you're the next person, whether you lost it and you get it back or you hit it for the first time, you will get that invite. So hopefully you all also know we have a weekly coach sneak peek. If you're brand new, all you do is add them to mine. You don't have to reinvent the wheel. If you run your own fit clubs, I suggest you run your own sneak peeks, because it's genius to me that you can have a Facebook group that stays open, because most people aren't going to join you the first time. And you know that by now. So having a sneak peek group is basically like having a prospect list. You can look at that group anytime. As long as they don't leave the group, you have people that you're collecting so you can be able to go back and follow up with them. Maybe it's a month later, maybe it's 2 weeks later, maybe it's 6 months later. But if they're still in that group, they're still someone you should be communicating with. Okay, so I host them on Fridays. I have the same Google Docs that go up. I put them up, I take them down. This past Friday, we also experimented with a little sip and share. So me, Marie, and Amanda went live for a couple minutes, and that was fun. We kind of ended the sneak peek with a little bit of personal story. But regardless, it's just easy. It's a system. And if you want to be more successful in this business, have more systems that you can fall back on that literally take the guesswork out of your business so that your precious time is spent communicating one-to-one with people. That is what will grow your business. Your systems will run your business, 90% of it, okay? Your attention needs to go to your communication. Leadership Zooms on Saturdays, I love them. It's such a great Saturday morning to talk to everyone and to hear from other people. It's not like this, where you guys listen to me. Thank you for listening to me. It is a conversation. You must have at least 4 active coaches and be achieving Success Club. Again, it all goes back to Success Club. Every month to maintain or gain for the first time your spot in our leadership Zoom. And you'll know if you qualified because you'll be added to the group message. I'm joking. And I do create an event in Team Glow, which goes to everyone. No, not everyone qualifies for it, but I want that to be a little FOMO for you. I want you to see that notification and be like, darn it, I didn't qualify yet. But guess what? That's my goal to end out September. Or that's my goal for October. I'm going to get in that leadership Zoom. Okay. Business plan of the day goes up every weekday morning. I also start including it on the weekends, though it's way less structured, as you can see. And again, you guys, it's a system. So I'm sharing with you, hey, Tuesdays, I can tell you right now, I'm going to post about a piece of my story unrelated to health and fitness. I already know that. Wednesdays are typically the days I go live. Sometimes I go live Thursdays and talk about my coaching journey. But Thursdays are always going to be about coaching and where I'm going with this business. So it's just easy. I just take the guesswork out of my post schedule. I still bring genuine words and new posts every week, but it's the same themes each day, just like our Fit Club runs. So again, if you followed me around for a day, you'd probably be super bored because I am so routine oriented. I have so many systems in place that I can dedicate my time to talking to people. And that is why you see me at the top of the Success Club board every month, because that's where most of my time goes, communicating. And then push to Emerald. I noticed that the calendar kind of hides in the announcement section of Team Glow. You might not even know there was an announcement section. Cool. But I'm going to repost the monthly calendar now every Sunday. It was a good reminder for me so that you can see laid out in the month what we have going on. And you can see how I'm making this duplicatable as you're growing your team to plug them into resources. Like this past Thursday was our new coach training that was live streamed. And then that means that this week is the push to Emerald Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Okay. And then next week will be the new coach training. So it really goes back and forth. And all you need to do, again, when you bring on people that have an interest in this business, is not reinvent the wheel and freak out and create a bunch of systems, but is just to plug them into what's already given to you and then to build that relationship with them behind the scenes. Hopefully everyone got a chance to listen. I actually didn't listen to the full wake up call. I logged on to hear Brandy. But the Unstress program is now available on BOD. Awesome. I already did day one of it today. And you guys, if you know me, you know meditation has been part of my morning routine for months, probably years. I used to do just 5 minutes of silent meditation, but I'm really excited to bring in the Unstress because that truly, I can feel the days I don't meditate. And I do have a yoga background, but again, like I'm so far removed from that time in my life. I can tell you I'm not like a very like whatever person, but meditation is so huge. Meditation helps me be more patient, less reactive. And not only that, meditating before I open up my social media, which is so important, helps me set the tone for the type of day that I'm going to have, not have social media set it for me. Okay. I hope you all add in the 21-day meditation to your routine, wherever you can fit it in. I recommend the morning. I do it after my workout. But again, watch the National Wake Up Call if you haven't to get more information. 30-day breakaway. Hopefully you all know about our event. It's open for everyone, every coach, every prospect from now until September 27th. And we're just having fun with it. We'll just post random things in there, invite people. If they click that they're going, we obviously want to take that to a personal message. But after the 27th, if you run groups with me, don't worry, I'll explain it. If you run your own groups, that's when you split into running, opening up your official test group. Okay. I'll go over my little timeline in just a second. Your first week in business file. So this is really targeted to people that are bringing on coaches and or really starting to develop coaches on their team that want to learn more about the business. I recommend take that file in Team Glow, copy it, get on your computer. Don't do everything from your phone. Copy it from your computer, paste it in an email to yourself. Break out the 5 different days, or I think it's 6 technical days, and save them as emails, okay? When a new coach signs up that wants to work their business, I have an automated email system. Don't worry about that. You don't need to do that. Just send them an email a day. Don't tag them in that file in Team Glow because that's way too much information. They're going to ignore it. But email them day one, then tomorrow, day two, then Wednesday, day three. Don't worry if they respond or not, but give them in their email inbox a coach training. Because I guarantee you, if they do those coach trainings and follow the emails, you don't have to reinvent it. It's right there. And they're texting you every day like, hey, I did my coming out post, or here it is. Hey, I have questions about this. They have interest in building their business, right? What's the next step? Well, the next step is plugging them into the next new coach training that's basically a recap of everything, and then getting them into the push to Emerald, okay? And I will tell you, if they have done all those emails that you have sent and created from this file, they have earned a one-to-one call with you. I protect my time fiercely, and I really don't give new coaches a ton of one-on-one time until I know, are you going to work your business? Are you going to be coachable? And if not, it's okay. I'm still going to love you and support you. I'm just not going to give you an hour of my time that I'd be on Zoom when I could be working my business. Do you know what I mean? That's just being smart with your time. And lastly, just to like, that sounds a little counterintuitive, but it's not. Communicate with customers and coaches daily. I don't mean hop on endless one-to-ones with them. I mean, text message, voice memo, Facebook message, check in with them. Be a friend, be a person. You're not their therapist. Don't let them unload on you all the time, but know that you're there to help them see results. Because when someone gets consistent on their health journey and they love Beachbody products and programs, they are the most amazing coaches because they already understand discipline. Do you know what I mean? You don't have to be like, hey, did you work out? Did you drink your shake? Like, they're going to do it. Now you add in the personal development piece and the business activities. All right, so I'm going to let Tessa explain this, but we have something very exciting that I hope you don't all get scared of. I hope you get excited about, because I'm pumped for this. What I realized is with checking in nightly, I know some of you do it, some of you don't. I think you should, but I can't make you do anything. I know that it's more accountability when you know what you're doing directly affects other people, right? Not in a bad way, and that's just how the world works. So what Tessa kind of came up with this idea, and we met and we kind of hashed it out, is doing what you see with the September point system, which was kind of my trial run. That's all I do. I just try things out. We're going to take the September point system and change them into more of a team environment. So Tessa, you want to unmute yourself? I'm going to let you explain, and then we'll get back to this.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. So fantasy football, I kind of actually got the idea from a Boss Babes graphic that I felt like they didn't do it justice, so I changed it up and for us. But so what we're going to do is we're going to have teams, and each team will have like matches each week. So like two teams will be playing each other, and you'll have team captains, and your team captains or someone on the team, it doesn't matter who does the points, will collectively collect your team's points for the week, and you get points for, for logging your tracker, for signing coach or customer, I think it's 5 points, for connections, we're adding connections to this one, for invites, for coach invites, I think that's all of them. And then you also get penalty points. Your penalty point is not showing up for the day. And then for teams, since it is going to be during October when we're doing the new test group of the new program, we are going to be signing up a bunch of new coaches. So what we decided was if someone on your team goes inactive or goes for 3 or more days, you have the option to trade. So you can trade that team player for a new coach. So if that's the case, you're welcome to reach out to Ashley and I, and we can help you and figure out who, if any of the new coaches want to join our game. And if so, we can give you a new team player. This is supposed to be fun, and it's kind of like a take on Team Cup, except for you get the option to do trades and you have penalty points, obviously. But each week, like, we'll put 2 teams against each other, and then whoever wins for the week, like, we'll shout you out on Sundays. So points will count from Monday to Saturday, and then Sunday, Ashley and I will be behind the scenes doing, figure out who's playing for the next week and who won for that week. And then at the end of the month, whoever had, like, the most points or won the most, games, I guess, or weeks, we'll shout them out in the group and maybe give a prize. Not sure yet on that one. But yeah, so this is just to help those who are wanting to work the business. Don't be scared of doing it. It's supposed to be fun. I do recommend, once we have the teams, to start a group message, like a messenger group with your team, and like work together, like do power hours together if you want, shout each other out, help each other out in there, and just get to know people, because we want to mix it up. So you're not going to necessarily have people you know on your team. We want to like get to know more people. So that's my recommendation, and I think that's it, Ashley.
Yeah. Okay, thank you. And if you are wondering, yes, Tessa will be the numbers person, and I will not be, so don't worry about it. Yeah, and I think the only thing I wanted to add was, like, don't be scared. Like, if someone might have, I know we have some new coaches on the call, like, please don't be afraid of saying, well, I'm afraid of that, so I'm not going to participate. You guys can literally show up and say, it's Sunday, I did nothing, 1 point, see you tomorrow. You're not ghosting the group, you're checking in, but you're just showing that you're there. So like, I don't want anyone to like read this and be like, oh, that sounds fun, but that's not for me, you know? So Tessa, I'm gonna mute you, but unmute if I forgot anything. But I think the biggest thing to remember is like, we wanna do this because we wanna help you. And I know that team environments, just like we run fit clubs, are more helpful when other people know that they're helping each other out. So whether you've never gotten any Success Club point ever, or you signed up 24 hours ago, or you're feeling like, oh, September kind of stinks for me, I shouldn't do this. Everyone, if you're on this call and you're making time on a Monday night, you need to be on a fantasy football team. We're going to have captains. The captains are just going to be responsible for reporting in on the points each week, supporting their team, and we're going to make it fun. Like Tessa said, like this is literally supposed to be a good time, especially as we're heading into the holiday season, which let's be real, the holidays are 3 days. I don't know why it gets a whole season, but you're going to hear that excuse from people a lot, like it's the holidays. So we want to really drive into this last quarter, starting with something very exciting. And from that kind of birthed fantasy football. And I don't know anything about football, but we're going to call it fantasy football. So I hope you guys are excited. Tomorrow we'll do the official post to recap it and start selecting teams. We need to have all the teams locked in by September 30th. So you have a couple days, but you need to let us know ASAP, and I'll do like 10 reminders over the week. I'll make a list of who's in. We need to know who's in. We need to divide up the teams, and then you'll have your teams before October 1. Okay, guys, if there's any questions, I'm not going to monitor the chat while I'm going through this, but I'm sure Tessa can answer them. Please drop them in the chat box. We don't want you to be scared. We want you to be excited, and we want you to do this. Or if you're excited, be like, heck yeah, let's go. All right, back to the share. Okay, hopefully you all can see this. Real quick, I just wanted to share my workout plan. I always like to tell you guys and be super open about what I'm doing. So the only change is, you might have seen this from me last week or 2 weeks ago, I pushed back the start of my 30-day breakaway test group by 1 week because I want to do a launch week the week of October 5th. So our event ends September 27th. I'm going to host a separate Facebook group for my test group, but I will open the BOD app for anyone that wants to log there. So I'll have two options. But September 28th is going to be the week of like, hey, get to know you, get pumped up, 1 week until launch. So I'm going to add everyone because no one can obviously buy it yet. October 5th, start for me, you can do whatever you want. I'm just telling you what I'm doing. October 5th starts launch week. So we celebrate everyone who signs up. We make it really exciting and pumped up in the group. And then if they've not purchased 30-day breakaway by October 11th in the evening, which is a Sunday, they are removed from the test group. We start day one, October 12th. Cool. And I'm also running my regular Fit Club. That's not changing, but I really capitalize on test groups because there's something to be said for a new program and us all doing it together. So that's my only change. I'm going to do Sean week and then random BOD workouts and then, excuse me, acid reflux all the time. 30-day breakaway for October 12th. And then I just want to share with you guys what I'm doing for October, my Fit Club. I didn't even tell my co-host this yet, but here we go. We're doing all things fall. We like teams. Teams work a lot on our Fit Club because it's a bigger group. You guys might like teams. You might not. You might like accountability buddies, whatever works. We're going to do basically all things fall. So what I found, I don't know what you guys are doing or what works well for your own Fit Clubs, but I will tell you in my experience, simple, fun daily challenges. I know Sharon, amazing nutrition goals is cool, but like people would rather do a this or that. Like that's what people want. They want very easy, fun challenges. And the point is we want them to show up. So it doesn't have to be all let's be super nutrition and fitness focused in our daily challenges. It's let's have fun. Because if they're having fun, they're checking in, they're going to come back. We're also going to end October with Spirit Week. So the last week of October is going to be a different little theme every day, maybe like crazy socks or crazy hair or superhero. And we're going to give away a prize for the Fit Club team that's most spirited that ends that week. Do what you would want to participate in. That's what this means, you guys. If you're bored with your group, they're bored too. You need to have fun with it. You need to make sure you're enjoying it because that's the bread and butter of your business is getting people into that group. All right, let's jump right into quarter four goals and vision. I just need you guys to take a deep breath and lean in because I think this is really important. I think this is the reason that some people succeed in this business and some people can't seem to find their groove or their momentum. And I think it comes down to vision. You have to have a vision for your life. And this does not have to be complicated. But you guys, if you don't have something written down that makes you be like, wow, wouldn't that be awesome? Like, wouldn't that be so great? Then what are we going for? You know, like we have goals and we know we get up and we do the vitals and all that stuff, but you gotta really, and so for some of us, you've never done this. Before I was 25 years old, I never stepped back and thought like, what do I really want? Cause I just thought my life was just going like this and I was just gonna be a manager and then I was gonna be in debt and I was gonna get married and have a couple kids and have 2 weeks off a year and then die. Like that's, I never stopped to think my life could look differently than my example growing up or, you know, what I thought I had to do. So I want you guys, regardless of what you take from tonight, is please think about what peace means to you. Think about what excitement means to you. Think about if you're married, what you and your family or your spouse, like, what have you literally dreamed about that you're like, oh, that's a one day goal. You know, like for me, it was debt free. Like I did not think, I couldn't even imagine a world where I didn't have student loan debt. I couldn't imagine it. And that was part of my goal, my vision was I want to be debt free. I don't want to be locked into someone else forcing monthly payments of something that seemed like a mountain to pay off. Anyways, you have to know why you're working so hard and why you're here, because that's the gut check that's going to keep you showing up, keep you coming back, keep you from getting frustrated and saying things don't work or everyone ghosts you or whatever the story in your head is, and you're going to keep showing up. That is how the people on the National Wake Up Call have gotten on the National Wake Up Call. They had a vision, they have a vision that evolves as we grow, and they know why they're here. They know that little things in their day that happen, whether in the business or out of the business, does not deter them from where they're going. So vision versus goals. Goals are legitimate things that, for me, this is how it seems. Vision to me is like my 5-year out big dreams. Like I can achieve anything in 5 years. I can be a multimillionaire in 5 years. And I fully believe that. And I believe we are all capable of that. But that's not going to happen in 3 months. That's not going to happen in 6 months. That's not going to happen in 1 year. My vision is something that is like, we are working towards this and this is amazing. And I can't even really fathom the details yet. My goals are typically, I'm talking 30, 60, 90 days. Okay. They are tangible. They are a little scary, but they're achievable in the near future. So for me, that's not the, this is the Ashley definition, goals versus vision. Okay. Where do you want to be 3 months from now? You guys, October 21st, November 21st, in 3 months, it's December 21st. We will be 4 days from Christmas and we will be like 10 days from the end of this wonderful, crazy, ridiculous year of 2020. So when you're sitting here on a call, let's say it's a Monday night, 90 days from now, where do you want to be sitting as? Or do you not even want to be on this call because your team has grown so big you don't have time for my calls anymore unless I'm begging you to guest speak? That's what I want for you. But you, everything you do now, literally September 21st, 22nd, 23rd, is not for the date, this date. It is for December. Because what you guys, especially if you're new, it's hard to see this. Everything you do is pushing the wheel forward in your business. Yes, you have people that join, sometimes join right away, friends or family, or they see a transformation picture, of course. But 99% of your business is setting it up for 3 months from now. So when you look at 3 months ago and say, what was I doing back in May? It's probably a good indicator of where your business is at right now, provided you've been doing the same amount of work that whole time. Do you know what I mean? And then people come out of the woodwork and it's not because they've randomly thought of you. It's because of your consistency and your dedication and your understanding of trusting the process. So everything you do today is for end of the year. When times get crazy and holidays get crazy, you are setting yourself up now. And by the way, Beachbody is releasing a pretty awesome program in December that will help us out a lot. But you're doing stuff now for those people that are going to be ready to join you in December. Okay. My goal in 90 days is that we become a 10-star diamond elite team, which makes me vomit. We've already locked in elite, which is awesome. We are currently 2 weeks away from being a 6-star diamond team, but I want to be 10-star. And that means that they need to be, the goals need to be specific and measurable. Do you want to be a 2-star diamond? Cool. How many coaches is that? How many coaches, knowing that 1 in 10 or 1 in 15 coaches will actually work their business, how many coaches do you need to recruit between now and November to get to be at 2 people that want to build their business and want to build their business to diamond? Well, you should be looking at between 15 and 30 coaches to find your 2, right? This is all a numbers thing, you guys. It doesn't mean we don't care about people and treat people with respect and kindness, but you can't be holding on to 5 coaches and think we're going to get there. You're not. I mean, you're not. Like, you have to have minimum 20 to 30 coaches if you want to be a 2-star diamond team and have 2 runners, and one of them is probably your spouse. Okay? It's understanding the numbers, because then you don't get so down and so frustrated and so bothered when Susie says she's going to work her business and she doesn't do anything, or when you wake up to a coach cancellation email that you weren't expecting. Because you know it's cool and you know you led by example and you know this isn't for everyone, but you going forward makes sense for your goals. You understand what you're working for. So goals are specific and measurable and honestly more of the logistical side of the brain. Vision gives you the feels and the fire, okay? So how do we as Team Glow, how do I get to represent a 10-star diamond team? What does that look like? Well, for me, it means that we need 4 more coaches on our team to reach diamond leadership and maintain their team rank by November 10th. That's a goal. That's not a vision, that's a goal. And if you, yes, my goal is 10-star. If your goal is diamond coach or 1-star diamond coach, by the way, diamond coach means 8 coaches, 2 emeralds on your team, then reverse engineer it, okay? So we need on Team Glow current diamonds to hold their rank, which again means you're adding every month because some people will fall off, some people will go inactive to continue to grow. And this is what else I need. And I can't be more clear than just putting it all out there and being like, who wants to go? I need everyone who's serious about their business, which I hope is you because you're on a call on a Monday night, to consistently achieve Success Club. That's how you help the team, okay? Because I understand the numbers. I know not everyone's going to want to run for diamond. I understand. It doesn't bother me. I just want to know who wants to run for diamond. And I also want to know that you guys understand that helping 3 people a month is the bare minimum to move your business forward. That's what that means. Okay. Because otherwise I'm just setting you up for failure. If I'm like, it's okay. It's okay. No, if you want to build your business, that's got to be a non-negotiable 1000%. And that will move you forward very medium, very slow. 3 people a month is awesome, but you know, it's even better. 20 people a month, 30 people a month. All this is possible for you. We just have so many limitations coming into this of I can't seem to attract that many people. People tell me no. We have to work on our own personal development so much that these things become normal. You guys, I don't ever have to set a goal of hit Success Club this month. That will 1,000,000% happen. I just have to set the goal of what kind of numbers scare you this month. Success Club 80 scares me. That's my goal. I'm nowhere near that, but I'm pushing harder. So what can we do as a team? I need you guys to understand that, like, I understand some people work nights. You can give me, you know, some people have specific situations, I get it. But I will say as a whole, your morning routine needs to be locked in. It needs to be locked in. When you wake up and you take that first hour a day for yourself before your family, your job, your life needs you, you set the tone for the rest of your day. Coach and I had a one-on-one last week and she told me she was feeling down. We looked into her morning routine. The first thing she did was start scrolling her phone. And I'm like, no, 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 no. No more. Do not wake up and fuel your mind with social media. I love that we can build a business online. I love it. But I honestly love my relationship with social media because it's not pleasure for me. It is business. And when I'm done, I don't open it. Just like in the morning, I don't let those thoughts into my head, good, bad, or indifferent, before I've taken control of my morning. So I work out. I meditate. I add to my grateful list. I watch a training while I work out. 2 birds, 1 stone. That works for me. And then I begin to work my business, okay? Lock it in. My first hour of the day of business work, I am responding to unread messages and sending new messages because I understand the fluff stuff is checking into my Fit Club, is creating graphics, is checking into the team page, going live. That's all fun for me and I enjoy it. What moves my business forward is my inbox conversations, follow-ups, invites, and connections. So that's what I do. And it's just no secret. That's just what I do. So lean in. Also, be a part of Fantasy Fitball. Do this thing that we're working so hard to create for you because we want you guys to succeed. Like literally, I can't be a 10-star diamond team by myself and that'd be really boring for diamond weekends. If no one on the team got to diamond, I couldn't hang out by myself. Like I want this because I understand what it can do for your life because I'm sitting in a house that's living proof of it, right? Like, and this is not reserved for me. This is open to every single person who has the power, drive, and determination to see beyond what 90% of people that don't think network marketing works see. And they see long-term vision and not instant gratification. Because that's not how this works. That's how everyone wants it to work. Hold up a mirror and have a really honest talk with yourself. Are you doing the work that needs to be done every day? Are you? Are you working hard enough that if you unplug on Sundays, it's not a big deal? And if you're not, then that's something you need to own. Right? And also, do you believe that you're worthy of success? I think a lot of times we could be doing the work, but we don't actually believe that we're going to be that person one day that can speak on a call or that can lead a team or that can help anyone succeed. Because I was stuck in that mindset for 3 years. You have to validate yourself before you wait for anyone else to validate you. You already have everything you need to succeed. And what you don't have, you're going to grow into as you show up every day. You might not be someone who could lead a 15-star diamond team right now, but you can grow into that person. And you already have the skills to start growing into that person. So I'd like to know, answer in the chat. I always like to, you know, I don't really believe in motivation, but I think pushing for goals is fun. So as a leader of this team, I really would like to know, what is something that really fires you up? Are you motivated by gifts? Tank tops, right? Gifts like that. Are you motivated by trips/time together? Like the diamond weekend? Like the more I can understand, like what's the majority of our team get excited about? Are you motivated by money? If you're like, I don't need a gift. I don't need a trip. If I see my paycheck grow, I'm good, right? Or is it something else? So I'm going to look at this at the end of the call, but please drop it in the chat if any one of those resonate with you, or if you're like, honestly, I don't know. Well, if you don't know, we got to go back to your vision. But first, it's nice to know as a team, like, hey, would you push a little harder? Because I'm asking a lot in 90 days and I understand that. And I'm only going to work with the working. I'm not going to drag you. But I'd really like to know, how can I support you? Right? Like what would be more inspirational to you if we could address it? All right. And your action steps, you guys, when you write out your vision and you write out your end of the year goals, achieving your goals should go hand in hand with beginning to realize the vision of your life, which the vision can change. Mine's already shifting this year, but your goals, like my goals of being a top 10 team and earning $10,000 weeks, go hand in hand with, I want to live a life of financial freedom by the water. I want to tithe to our church and I want to help my mom financially. Do you see how that stuff goes hand in hand? Because they should. Your goal should be working towards your vision. The vision is the life that you maybe don't even believe you can have, but you wholeheartedly deserve. Be married to your routine. Be married to it. Be boring. Celebrate the boredom. Because I understand you've got a million things to do in your life. Be boring in your routine because that's your system. The more you can fall back on a system, it becomes a habit. The more a habit becomes something, it becomes a behavior. You guys on this call are not just going to stop working out, right? Unless you have a baby or you're injured. You're not going to stop because it's a system. So have the same system from your workouts that you do in your vital behaviors. Like, what are your non-negotiable numbers each day? If you're a new coach, maybe it's, I will talk to 10 new people 6 days a week. Is that overwhelming? I mean, I don't know. I don't think so. But if you could talk to 10 new people and have 60 new conversations a week, over 200 new conversations a month, a lot of those turning into invites, 3 people a month is going to be achievable for you, if not more, much more. The other thing to think about is, what will you do the day after you don't have an amazing work day? Because that day is going to happen. What do you do the next day? If you need personal accountability, if you know that you thrive on this, number one, fantasy football is your jam, but number two, ask for it. Ask me, ask the team. If you need someone to be like, I need you to text me every day at 5 p.m., they might need that too. Lean into what you need and what other people are working towards as well. Reverse engineer your goals, you guys. This is so important. Do you want to be a diamond coach in 6 weeks? Like, we talk about diamond a lot because it represents leadership, maxing out on cycle volume, helping us with team goals. 8 coaches, 2 emeralds. Can I break this down for you really quick? If you sign up 2 controlled family member accounts, mom, husband, best friend, whatever it is, not best friend, husband, sister, whatever, you can be a diamond coach in 6 weeks by recruiting 2 coaches a week. Is that overwhelming? To me, it's not, right? But you have a goal and you have a plan to get to that goal. And even, let's say signing someone up that's a secondary business is out of the question. Okay, so sign up 2 to 3 coaches a week. In 6 weeks, you will have more than enough to possibly have your 1 or 2 want to build their business and push for emerald themselves. Very simply, because you have pushed to emeralds every other week. We have incentives. You have the systems that I've created. No, go after it and get people plugged into that, right? The more you talk about this as very easy to achieve, the less objections you're going to get. Know your systems provided by me. I do this because I love you, but also because you don't need to reinvent the wheel. I want you to have 99% of your business time in direct communication with prospects, coaches, and clients, okay? Follow-ups and all that stuff. So you know you have a new coach trained to plug them into live every other Thursday night. You know you have a push to emerald the following Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday of those off weeks of the new coach training. You know there's a file in Team Glow that says your first week in business that you can copy and email to new coaches daily when they've signed up. Is all this kind of making sense? And then all you have to do is communicate with them. Watch what they do. Do not give your time until your time has been earned, meaning in a one-to-one setting, but support the crap out of them for their health goals. And last, you guys, what is your pain points for making this business work, okay? For me, I was a paycheck to paycheck server, three-time corporate America dropout, $50,000 in student loan debt, and that sure as heck was my pain point. I hated coming off of a 12-hour workday smelling like a fryer and being embarrassed that I wasn't using my college degree and not having any way to see my fiance slash husband because he worked a professional golf job that kept him away for crazy hours and I worked 12-hour serving shifts and we had no time together. That was a pain point, right? And I didn't want to live in a small one-bedroom apartment the rest of my life. So what's your, not that that's all got to be financially driven, it could be time driven. It could be like family time. Like what's your pain point for saying this has to work? It's not if this works, I'll give it 3 months. No, this has to work. And I'll give it as long as I need to give it. I wouldn't even reevaluate your business and your goals before 1 year because it takes time. Like when people it's a red flag, I'll be honest, when people tell me, well, yeah, I'm not quitting the business, but I'm like, oh, well, I won't be seeing you on more calls because they've already given themselves that way out. Even telling me I'm not quitting, but just by you saying that, you've already put it on the table. It's like in marriage counseling or advice when they say, like, if you even put divorce on the table, it's on the table. It needs to be so far from the table, it's getting cold in the backyard. Quitting is not an option if you are serious about growing your business. And last, I'm going to go through these really quick, but communicate with your upline. I know that I can speak for every other leader on the team, we want to know who wants to run because I'm not dragging anyone. I can't drag you. All I can do is support you, but I'm going to match your pace. And listen, you guys, what got you to this rank and this goal in your journey is not going to get you to the next rank. Yes, some coaches will still be with you. Many won't, and many won't be working their business in 3 months, and that's okay. But because you recruit new people every month, you constantly have new energy, new joy, and you can work with your people that are still with you because you will have some lifers and that'll be fun. Your job is to be on your journey. Communicate with your team and customers and lead by example. And here's what I want to say about Success Club. People are not numbers, okay? I don't want you to think just get the numbers. People are people. But Success Club is a benchmark that shows that your activities are compounding and you have new lifeblood in your team and in your fit clubs every month. And if there is anything that combats the feeling that you can't do this, you're not worth it, fit club's boring, no one's working their business, it's bringing new people on, okay? So yes, Success Club is a point system, but Success Club means that the cumulative efforts of your daily belief, action, and sense of worth is growing your business month after month, right? If you were in a sales job, you would have sales quotas. We have Success Club. And you're not a failure if that doesn't happen 1 month, but I will tell you, what if that was just taken off the table? What if Success Club was as non-negotiable as not quitting this business? How would your business look in 3 months? Well, you'd at least make $150 every month, if not more. You must be talking about the business to attract to the business. If you're only ever talking about your health journey and your shakes and your nutrition, you're never going to attract people that want to build a business. But know that it takes 5 to 8 points of contact with someone on average for anyone to typically make a decision. Many of y'all haven't followed up with people 8 times yet. So how do you know if they want to do this or not? It takes people time. You have to trust the process. You cannot hold your breath if someone says, I'm signing up on Friday. They probably won't. That's okay. But you have to keep them in your follow-up system and know that it might not be today or tomorrow or 30 days later. They might come to you 6 weeks down the road and be like, I'm ready. Because that goes into trust the freaking process. You can't know if a system works unless you've been doing it for months. You can't. You can't be like, I tried this for a couple of weeks. You talk about the business every day. You talk about the business every Thursday in a post, every day on your stories. You talk about your health journey. You talk about your family. You talk about that for months and months, and then you look back and you see the momentum you're creating. You don't just try it for 2 weeks and be like, it didn't work. Sneak peeks don't work. Going live doesn't work. Yes, it does, girl. And yes, social media changes and we have to be aware of that. But what's not going to change is showing up and being consistent. That's never going to go away. It's not going to change. And have fun with ghosts. Guys, don't let ghosts annoy you. Have fun with them. Be like, girl, what's up? Send people voice messages. If they're ghosting your invite process when they were interested, follow up with something completely unrelated. I've lately just been thanking people for watching my stories. If they've been ghosting me forever, I'm like, girl, thanks for watching my stories. Thank you. Thanks so much for the support. Thank you. Like, I'm pouring out the love because I don't know if they're going to come back to me, but I do know they're watching me. So that's my duty. And then 2 minutes of inspiration, then we'll be done. So I always think, like, what do I want to tell you guys today or this week? And I want to tell you the story of mediocrity because that's what I always believed I was. Growing up, I was a mediocre athlete. I was sat on the bench more than I played. I was a mediocre student. I was smart, but I wasn't like book smart. I had to work really hard at it. I thought I was mediocre in my looks. I didn't really have a ton of confidence. And I thought I was mediocre in my personality to the point where I would literally be a chameleon and change. It took me like 15 years. Like, one of my best friends now, we're still best, like great friends. She's very outgoing and bubbly and funny. And I would just think I was like her. And I'm like, I'm not like her at all. Finally, in the last 3 years, I'm like, I'm a huge introvert. She's a huge extrovert. But yet I would change my personality because I just wanted to be like her because to me, she was well-liked. I never even knew there was a life for me aside from debt, management positions, and 2 weeks off of vacation per year. Like, that's what I thought my life was. I was never the most popular. I was never the one to fit in naturally. I felt like I had to force my personality into a mold to be liked and accepted. And the truth was, I was embarrassed. And it like sucks to say, but I was embarrassed by the house, which was the only thing my mom could afford. I was embarrassed by the car that I was forced to pay for myself for $900 and get a 94 Saturn. What up, what up? But I was embarrassed by it. Looking back, that's the best lesson I ever learned, was work hard and never give up. But I was embarrassed. I was embarrassed by not being able to afford things that my other friends could afford. And I had to hide the fact that we were pretty much poor. And I thought that went into not being well-liked. We couldn't afford training for me to be a good athlete. Couldn't afford braces. So I had crooked teeth until I was 25. And that was my life, you guys. So whoever you see now is not, like, this is not the person that was 17 years old and 21 years old. I carried this insecurity with me through my entire 20s, to the point where, actually in my mid-20s, coaching at 24 years old brought me hope. After 2 years of being a coach, but yet ignoring the gift that I could really dive into with development, leadership, and financial opportunity, I finally allowed myself to dream and create that vision. Coach Summit slogan in 2014, I'm pretty sure it was Dream Big. That might've been the next year, but it was, to me, it was Dream Big. And that was the first summit I went to. And I finally allowed myself to start dreaming big. And that big goal was debt freedom. And I don't know why it's all connected, but it was, because that was my huge Achilles heel. It took me 5 years from setting that goal in 2014. But in May of 2019, we got there. We paid off our entire debt except our house. It took 5 years of overcoming limiting beliefs. It actually took a lifetime of overcoming limiting beliefs that I would never get beyond mediocrity. And honestly, I was stuck in mediocrity in my coach business for years because I thought, you've gotten here, just like high school, you've gotten here, you're doing okay, but you're not up here. You're not in the upper echelon. You're not going to get there. And I finally stopped telling myself that story. I sure as hell blasted through the limiting belief that, why not me? Yeah, I am not a Barbie looking model mom that some top 10 coaches are. I could put in X, Y, and Z of why this is not meant for me. And it's crap. It's complete crap because I am in control of my destiny. And no matter who joins me or doesn't join me or what someone thinks of me or the car that I drive or the house that I have or the clothes that I wear, it doesn't matter because now I'm validated. And what I hope to teach my daughter is she doesn't need fancy things to be accepted. She needs to accept herself and work hard and overcome the limiting beliefs that are going to come her way. I just hope she can recognize them a lot sooner than it took me. It doesn't have to take you 5 years of unlearning your past to write a new future. But if it did, would it be worth it? And you can fill in the blank of whatever you want. Maybe it wasn't the mediocrity in high school that haunts you. Maybe it's something that happened in your past. Maybe it's something that you feel like it's a goal you're just never going to achieve, whatever it is. But what if it took 5 years of working on yourself and then you could overcome that? What if it took 10 years? What if it took 10 months? Would that be worth the day in and day out hard work that you put in? Because this business is not just about the workouts and the shakes, you guys. The business is about the person you become in the process. The business is about not complaining about things that happen, but know that life is happening for you, not to you. And if someone has done it, it is possible for you. Do you understand? There's a top 10, I don't know if she's still in the top 10, but she has a private Instagram account. She has like 2,000 followers. Right? So whatever your limiting belief is that I can't grow my business because I have 100 followers on Instagram, or I live in a small town, or I X, Y, and Z, it, none of it is true. If you have enough to have Wi-Fi and social media, you have enough. You just have to start taking action and believing it and knowing that daily action will create momentum. So you guys, I hope that was a little bit inspiring. We will be a 10-star Diamond Elite team in 2020 while qualifying for 2021. I don't know how it's gonna happen yet. I need to have at least 4 coaches pop out of the woodwork and wanna run for Diamond. But here's the thing, I trust the process. And here's the thing, if we don't get there, we're gonna be way closer than if I didn't believe this was possible. Because I do. I've seen coaches go Diamond in 5 weeks. I know we have time. I know you have time, but you're wasting it every time you tell me why this something isn't working this month. Girl, save your breath and go work. That's what you need to do. And I'm not saying don't be human and don't be frustrated about things, but where are you putting your energy? What wolf are you feeding in your heart? The one that says you can do this, positivity is, this is what's overcoming, or the one that says, yeah, you're gonna keep facing stuff like that. Yeah, this business doesn't work. Whichever one you feed is going to grow. And at the same time, you need to work hard, but have grace with yourself. If life is crazy and you need a day, you take a day. But you cannot take a week off of your vitals and expect your business to be there. Not at this point in your business. Maybe when you're a top 10 coach, can you take it? Even then, that would scare me. But you do not have the luxury of putting your feet up and saying, I'm gonna put it on the back burner. Your vision for your life doesn't deserve that. And you shouldn't need me to tell you this every week, but if you need me to, I will. You're already validated as a leader. You have to start seeing yourself the way I see you, or you aren't going to grow. And I know that some of y'all are going to quit. I know it. I know maybe not quit too, but some of y'all are going to fall off. And some of y'all, the holidays are going to get the best of you. And I'm not going to hear from you until January 2021. I know that. I just also want to know who's going to be with me. So I'd like 10 Star Diamond leaders on our team to be earning at least $300 a week. I would like the one percenters, the people that push and achieve 2-star, push for premier, which is maintaining leadership points, which just means you're helping your team, earning $1,000 a week by the end of the year, because I believe that's possible. And I believe the 99% that can become Emerald coaches and achieve Success Club is possible. I believe that our team can become the most powerhouse Success Club consistent achieving team that Beachbody has ever seen. And I know it because I do it. And you know what I want to see is I want to see someone believe in themselves so much that they beat me next month in Success Club points. Because you can. The only thing I might be doing differently is I've been doing it for longer and I do it every day, except Sundays. So I hope this was helpful, you guys. I'm going to end the recording. Stay hang tight for a boomerang.